So one of the most important things in getting off to a good start is making sure that you're planting at the correct seeding rate. And if you look at the North Carolina Small Grain Production Guide in the chapter on seeding rates, you'll see that if you're planting on time with high quality seed and you're planting with conventional tillage, our recommended seeding rates are 1.3 to 1.5 million seeds to the acre. Now, I know most growers usually think about pounds of seed to the acre. So to convert those seeding rates of 1.3 to 1.5 million seeds to the acre to how many pounds of seed per acre that is, you need to know what your seed size is of the variety that you're interested in. So let's say that you're interested in, you're going to be planting this variety that we have right here. And if you look at the label on the bag, it'll always tell you how many seeds there are in a pound. On the variety that we're planting, there are about 12,000 seeds to the pound. So if we go back to the Small Grain Production Guide, back to the table on the seeding rate chapter. So this one had 12,000 seed in a pound, so right here is 12,000. And if we look across that row, it says we need to be planting somewhere between 109 and 127 pounds of seed to the acre. So the way you'd start by doing that is you'd go to the chart on the drill box that the manufacturer provides and see what they recommend you set your drill at. Now, it's important to realize that the numbers that they give you on these charts are just crude estimations. So we wanted to be planting somewhere between 110 and 100 and say 27 pounds to the acre. So let's go up there and see what that actually looks like on this chart. The top of the chart is wheat, and if we go across to about 120 or so pounds and look up, that says that this manufacturer recommends that we set this drill at a setting of about 26 to get that seeding rate. So if I go back down here, I'm going to move this lever over to the 26 notch, and that's right there. And now we're ready to go ahead and see whether we're actually putting out that number of seeds. Now, one of the easiest ways to test this is to see whether we're putting out the correct number of seeds in a linear foot of row. Now, how do you find out what that is? Again, you go back to the Small Grain Production Guide to that table, and you check your manufacturer's row spacing. So the row spacing on this drill is 7.5 inches. You go to the table here and you look up drill row spacing. There's 7.5 inches right there. And you look across and that says, I want to be planting between 19 and 22 seeds per linear foot of row. If I'm doing that, I know I'm planting at the correct seeding rate. So to make that a little bit easier, we've wired up this closing wheel so that it doesn't close the row. We've reduced our down pressure on this drill as low as we can, and we've picked a fairly hard bit of ground to actually run on. A driveway is a good surface to do this on, or a really hard packed gravel or sand driveway or road. Something that the seed isn't actually going to get buried in the ground, but will be left on the surface, so it's easy to count how many seeds there are that the drill's putting out. So we've run the drill at the setting that we estimated it should be at of 26, and we've run it with no down pressure and with the closing wheels lifted up. And that's left the seed right on the surface of the driveway here, and I'm going to measure, count how many seeds there are in 3 feet of row. So I'm going to take my tape, and here's the beginning of my 3 feet right there. Here's the end of my 3 feet right there, and I'm going to count how many seeds that we got in that 3 feet of row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51 seeds in 3 feet of row. And what we said was is that our optimum seeding rate was going to be between 19 and 22 seeds per foot of row for this drill. So to convert that, I'm going to take out my calculator, and we've got 51 seeds in 3 feet of row. I'm going to divide that by 3, and that's 17. So it's a little bit too low. We wanted between 19 and 22. So in this case, the manufacturer's recommendation was a little bit on the low side, and we actually need to increase that setting and then run the drill again until we get the number of seed in a foot of row somewhere between 19 and 22. What about if you have a situation where you've got a drill that's too wide to make a pass on a hard surface like a driveway like this? Or if you want to calibrate your drill during the winter in your shop, so you're going to be doing it in a place where you can't run it and actually see how many seeds you're getting in a foot of drill row. In that case, you're going to need to lift up your drill and turn your tire and go through a slightly different procedure, and we're going to go through that next.
We have reset the drill for the desired seed rate, 19 to 22 seeds per foot of row. And for the next method of calibration, we will mark the tire and the ground, travel the distance of 5 revolutions, measure that distance, and divide the number of revolutions into the distance traveled. That will establish the correct circumference of the tire. The 5 revolutions is just to reduce the margin of error. You may want to measure more or less depending on your degree of accuracy needed.
33.3 divided by 5 revolutions, that's 6.66, which is 6 foot 8 inches. Mm-hmm. All right.
We might as well say 80 inches, and I think we got something to go with. Mm-hmm. So what we need to do now is we can turn that wheel 5 revolutions and divide our seed by 80 inches, and we've got it.
That's right. That'll give us our seed per foot.
One of the things you have to do once you have your bucket in place to catch the seed is to turn the wheel a little bit to make sure you have seed flowing, because sometimes you got to fill the cup, seed cup. So let's turn that until we get it. We know we got seed flowing. And I'm gonna stop at a position and not let that wheel roll backwards. I'm gonna hold that, clean your cup, and then we're gonna drop it, and we're gonna turn this wheel 5 times. You ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. All right, I'm gonna hold it, take the cup out. All right, now we're gonna count the seed. At this point, you can just lay the seed out on something. I have a piece of cardboard here, but most time the seed bag that you use to fill the drill works very well. I usually count in groups of fours and then count out 25 groups and make little piles of 100, because there's a lot of seed here, and sometimes you'll be counting a couple hundred seed easy. So I just count out little, that way I don't lose count.
Okay, that's 310 I got, Bert.
Okay, your 310 and my 400 there is 710. Okay, so we have 5 revolutions times 6.66 is 33.3 feet. So we take the 710 divided by 33.3, gives us 21.32 seed per foot. I think we're right on target, Ron.
Absolutely, Bert.
So another important thing, once you have measured your wheel to get your circumference, write that on the drill somewhere, because that's very important. You don't want to lose that, because that will not change unless you change the wheel size, and I've had to change the tires. So keep that in mind, to keep that, and you always have that to calculate by. But another way to calculate, Ron, is similar to that. Tell us a little bit.
Exactly, Bert. A lot of times we calculate by measuring off 50 feet and then catching the seed as we drove across that 50 feet, and basically doing the same thing we just did, count the seed out and see how many seed that ends up being for that 50 feet. For example, if your target rate was 20 seed per linear foot of row and you did 50 feet, that would give you 1,000 seed that you would need to count out. But that is another option that you could look at as well. There's many ways to do it. The main point is to calibrate that grain drill. As we've already indicated, it is critically important to getting off to a good start with your wheat crop.
And that way is very critical. That's a field ready when the ground's been broke, you loose ground, you don't have hard grain to do the test on, you're not in the shop anymore. We just demonstrated a technique that you can do in the shop. As long as you know the circumference of the tire, you can do that in the shop during the winter months and have your machinery ready to go when you pull out there in the field. And catching it on 50 foot, that's when you're in the field and you're ready to go. You want to double check your accuracy. So it's all good points that we can use.
Absolutely.
The nice thing about this approach to calibrating a drill is that once you figure out your seeding rate, you always know how many seeds you want in a foot of drill row. However, it's important to remember that if you change varieties or if you go from one seed treatment to another seed treatment on this, even the same variety, that you were probably going to have to change the setting on the drill to get that same number of seeds per drill row foot. So it's important to recalibrate your drill for every variety and every seed treatment that you're using. The other thing that's important to remember is these numbers that I just talked to you about, 19 to 22 seeds per foot of drill row for planting on, are for planting on time and for high quality seed and conventional tillage. If you're no-tilling, you need to increase your seeding rate. If your germ on your seed is low, you need to increase your seeding rate. Or if you're planting late, you need to increase your seeding rate. And how to do that and how to adjust your seeding rate based on all those different factors is covered in the seeding rate chapter in the Small Grain Production Guide.
This program is funded by the North Carolina Small Grain Growers Association.